Blackstone Audio presents The Hermit by Thomas Rydahl, translated by K.E. Semmel. This book is read by Victor Bevine.
Luisa, 31st December. 1. On New Year's Eve, under the influence of a triple Lumumba,
Erhard decides to find a new girlfriend.
New is probably not the right word. She doesn't need to be new, or attractive, or sweet, or fun. Just a warm body. Just one of those kinds of women who potters about the house. Maybe she'll hum a song or curse at him because he spilled cocoa on the floor. What can he ask of her? Not much. And what does he have to offer her? Not much. But it won't get any easier. In a few years, she'll also need to empty his piss pot and shave him and pull off his shoes after an entire day in the car, if he can still drive, that is, in a few years. The mountainside near the house is invisible. The darkness is complete. If he sits still long enough, he'll suddenly be able to see the stars. And if he sits even longer than that, he'll see a narrow band of shooting stars growing brighter and brighter. The silence grows, if one can put it that way. Grows like the sound of nothingness, drowning out the heat of the day still whining in the rocks, and the wind's relentless C major, and the beat of the waves lashing against the coast, and the blood that's seeping through his body. A silence that makes him want to weep into the new year. A silence that's so convincing, so satiating, that it blends with the night and his wide-open eyes, which feel closed. This is what he loves about living out here where no one ever comes. Just him and Laurel and Hardy. And here come the stars. They've always been there, but now he can see them. First all the specks, then all the constellations and Orion's belt and the galaxy like an old-fashioned punch card with messages from the Big Bang. It's been 17 years and 9 months since the last time. He smells Beatrice's perfume, which practically clings to his shirt, right where she touched him this afternoon as they parted. She suggested that he come along tonight, a half-hearted attempt, if even that. "I've got plans," he'd said tartly, the way only an old man can. "Come on," she'd tried again, sweetly. "No thanks, those people are too fancy for me." Which they were. She didn't say anything to that. Instead, Raoul said, "You are one of the finest people I know." But nothing more was said about it. And when they began arranging the champagne flutes, he gave Beatrice a happy New Year's kiss and left. Raoul walked him out. "Buen viaje," Erhard said, when they stood among the distinctive throng on the street. From the opposite pavement, the suitcase salesman, Silon, shouted Happy New Year to them, though mostly to Raoul, whom everyone knows. Erhard headed to his car, feeling the same pang that struck him every New Year's Eve. Another year gone like all the rest. Another year looming. "Cheers, my friend. It's good with cognac. It burns all the way down. The night is warm. His body is tingling hot now. Maybe because he's thinking of Beatrice, her dark place, right where her breasts part and vanish into her blouse, the very source of her aroma. Damn. He tries not to think about her. She's not the one he should be spending his time on. The hairdresser's daughter, he can think about her. There's something about her. He's never met her. He has seen her once at a distance. He's often seen her image on the wall in the salon. He thinks about her. He thinks about simple events. Little scenes where she walks into the salon, the bell above the door chiming. He imagines her sitting across from him at the dinner table when he eats, or standing in the kitchen, his kitchen, preparing steaming, sizzling food on the stove. In truth, she's much too young, absorbed in things he doesn't understand. She's not exactly his type. What could he possibly say to impress a young woman? She probably doesn't even cook. She'd probably rather talk to her friends on the telephone, like all young people do. Maybe she eats noodles out of a small box while staring at her computer screen. In the image at the salon, she's a teenager and the very picture of innocence, with thick curls.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.